hard, no photos, baby. Fuck around with you, I've been throwed off lately. Heard shit through the grapevine. You want time, I'ma take mine. Gucci belt for her waistline. Say you down, gotta stay down.
What's poppin', y'all? It's your boy, One Tree Rock. Like and subscribe, give me a play. Alright. So I want to get into my Sixers to begin with, man. I like what I'm seeing, but I also got a couple complaints, man. Like on some real, I don't like Danny Green and Steph Curry on the court at the same time, man. It's not a good like matchup to me. It's like one giving you 3 points, the other giving you 4 points. 22 minutes, 25 minutes. I'm like, how you on the court that long? You only putting up 3 and 4 points. It's hurting the team for real. I'd rather see Seth starting and Danny coming off the bench with the second team. Like, maybe he'd get more of a spark. I don't know. But, like, that's not going to cut it. We get to the playoffs and they only putting up 4 points and 5 points a game. We're going to lose. We're going to get swept. But I do like Embiid going off, man. He went off against Utah. Dropped 40 points. 40 points, 19 rebounds, 3 assists, and he hit the three to send it into overtimes. And for all the people that was doubting Tobias Harris, man, that boy, he could be our closer, man. You saw what he did against Utah. They gave him the rock, and he just said, get out the way. I got a little guy on me. He scored damn near all our points in the overtime. I mean, I like that. Like, he give, like, that's how Melo used to be, man. Melo, man, give me the rock and just get out my way, man. Tobias Harris, he looked motivated this year. Doc got him in the right offense. Ben Simmons, he doing his thing, man. All that, y'all talking about all the shooting and threes and all that. He doing his thing, man. He playing his game. Like, and I like it. And then Dwight Howard and Shake Milton, they both gave you 12 off the bench. Kirkmaz gave you 8. So it's like, damn, like, I like the team, but it's just, I don't like Danny Green and Seth Curry starting together, man. I feel like we either need to put Thibault in there for the defense, or we need to put Shake Milton in and put him at the 2. Shake Milton give you buckets, man. But I don't like Danny Green in the starting lineup. I don't feel like him and Seth work well together on the court, man, because they just stand at the 3. They not no motion. They not doing nothing. So, I mean, that's the only complaints I got about my Sixers right now. So I'm gonna hop into the Eagles. It came out that Brandon Graham wanted to restructure his contract to be with the Eagles. And I that's what I love about BG, man. He always been a team player. He always put the team before himself. He not a selfish player. So, I mean, I can see him doing that. But yeah, it's still like BG's still getting old, and we don't know what's gonna happen with Derek Barnett. So it's like, I mean, our pass rush situation is a little bomb right now. But I mean, I feel like, man, they could get it right. I like Josh Sweat. I still love BG. I still love Fletch. But how long them dudes gonna be able to keep up the level that they playing at? That's why I always say we can't miss on these drafts, man. We can't keep missing on these draft picks. That's gonna set our team back for years. Cause eventually Fletch gonna retire. Eventually Brandon Graham gonna retire. And then the two anchors on our defensive line. So we got to find the next guys that's going to step up, or at least learn from them. We got to get a good D tackle, man. Even though we got Hargraves and we still got Fletch, we still got to get some young D tackles, man. Some D tackles that's hungry. They want to get in there and make plays. We got to get some young DNs. Because Derek Barnett, if he's on the team at the beginning of this year, they're going to have to pay him $10 million. So I don't know how that's going to go. But yeah, that's all I got to say about my Eagles right now, man. I'm just waiting to the draft. Like, it got me anxious right now. Like, I can't wait to see what go on in this draft, man. I feel like Howie Roseman probably going to botch it, but I mean, I can't wait to see. Like, I can't wait till football come back, period. But I want to get into some, I want to get into some draft profile, man. And I got a new guy for y'all, man. This guy is a freak of nature, man. If y'all ain't never seen him, after I'll tell y'all about this guy, go look up his highlights, man. Y'all not going to believe what y'all seeing. His name is Zaven Collins from Tulsa. He's 6'4", 260 pounds. But that boy out there moving like a Ferrari, man. And linebacker. He's a linebacker. Like, and I'm going to give y'all a rundown of just a little bit about Zaven Collins. Zaven Collins, man, this year alone, he had 36 solo tackles, 4 sacks, 2 forced fumbles, 4 interceptions. But that alone, like, that don't define his game. Like, dude is a playmaker at the linebacker. Let me say that again, and just in case y'all ain't hear me. He's 6'4", 260 pounds, moving like a gazelle out there. And if somehow he happened to slip to the second round, the Eagles can't pass on this dude, man. He's a generational talent, man. I got it. He going, 9 times out of 10, he's going in the first round. But, man, if he just so happened to slip to the, like, right there at the Eagles' second round pick, oh, my God, they can't pass. Like, we can't keep passing up on these freaks of natures, man. Like passing up on DK Metcalf, like. Like, we can't keep doing it. We'll never really get no generational talents. Like, dog, he finished his career. He played 3 years for Tulsa. He finished his career with 236 total tackles, 5 interceptions, 129 solo tackles, 7.5 sacks, 3 forced fumbles, 2 touchdown return on interceptions. Like, dude is a freak, man. I'm trying to tell y'all. Listen, if you understand the game of football, a game-changing linebacker, that means everything. A Brian Urlacher, a Ray Lewis, a Patrick Willis, a Luke Kuechly. That linebacker position, it just means so much to a team. If you got horrible linebackers, your team is going to be horrible, man. And you can't have average D-backs and horrible linemen, and your D-line just good. Your team gonna suck. Y'all not gonna be able to stop nobody. If the D-line can't get that pressure, y'all ain't gonna be able to stop nobody. But this dude, man, this dude is like, I'm gonna say it one more time. He's 6'4", 260 pounds. That's defensive ends in the NFL right now. That's a defensive end in the NFL. He running like a safety. Like, this, like, y'all, just check his highlights out right here, yo. This dude is moving like, you shouldn't be moving that fast at no 260 pounds, man. Like, that is crazy. Like, the Eagles need some game changers on defense, man, because I feel like our offense is going to be okay. We probably going to struggle at some points. If we don't get, like, a solid running back that's going to, we don't get like a solid running back that could get you to like a 2nd and 5 and not going to do all the dancing like Miles Sanders do. A running back that's going to hit the hole like a change of pace back. Like, if we don't keep Jordan Howard and we don't bring one of them in and we try to make Boston Scott our 2nd running back, it's not going to never work, man. Boston Scott is a 3rd down running back. He's a 3rd running back. He's a Darren Sproles type. He can't carry the load like a 5'11". 225 pound running back can. 230 pound running back can. Boston Scott is short and compact. He's not going to be able to, if Miles Sanders go down, Boston Scott going to be our first running back. So it's like, yeah, but like, go check out Zaven Collins, man. Go look up this kid highlights. He's a beast, man. But I'm One Tree Rock and I'm out of here, man. I love y'all.